What is up, Karatics? Welcome back to the series where I recustomize and review past DLC vehicles that didn't have good microphone quality before mid-2019. So as always, guys, feel free to let me know down below in the comments what car you want to see me recustomize next. I'll display the most liked vehicle suggestion comment in my next customization video. So in today's video, we're going to be customizing the Karen 190Z, which I did customize slash review in early 2018 when it released. So the 190Z released with the Doomsday Heist update drip feed in February of 2018, and it used to be available for a Legendary Motorsport website for a price of 900,000, but sadly it was a removed website car, which is a real shame. But as always, I'll leave a link to a video down below in the pinned comment explaining every method to get removed website cars. So in regards to performance, it's in the Sports Class S class and is a top 20 performing vehicle in the class for track performance, which isn't too bad. It's slightly above average in that class. Now, in terms of what the 190Z is based on, it's primarily based on the Datsun 240Z / Fairlady Z / Nissan S30, and it's mixed with a Toyota 2000 GT as well, which is a pretty interesting combination, but it does look great overall. But anyways, let's go ahead and check out the customization of the 190Z. Alright, 190Z, let's do it. Beautiful, beautiful car. Alright, arch covers. So you have all the different arch covers here, which unfortunately the wheel fitment doesn't adjust with the arch covers. It's just an issue in GTA Online when you have an upgrade like this. Just is what it is. But I'll still show them all here. You have all the different arch covers. This one even adds a side skirt too. Just a real shame that the wheel fitment just looks terrible at that angle there. But tons and tons of different options for... It's just so annoying. So I think we can, most of us can agree, you know, you should keep it stock because of the wheel fitment. There are people who glitch F1 wheels on here to kind of help make it look better, but I just think it looks terrible both ways, to be honest. So yeah, I'm gonna keep it stock. I think that's definitely the best route. Armor, brakes, bumpers. So you have removed the front bumper. Custom, which is just like thinner. Okay, you have the exposed bumper with a splitter, or just like a, I guess like a splitter built into the bumper, goes nice and low, looks good. Custom, you got the secondary, you got the carbon, you got sticker bomb, you got tuner bumper with the small bumper. Okay, and the splitter. Then you have a sports bumper with a splitter attached to the, I guess the splitter that's built into the bumper. With the little reinforcement brackets there. A little crazy. Alright, I think I'll go with a tuner bumper. I quite like that. We'll do that. Rear bumper, you can just remove it. Looks nice and clean. Then you have the hook bracket. Okay. You got the tow hook there. Then you have the stock bracket. So that's what, the stock bumper with the bracket there? Interesting. Okay. The tow hook. Ooh, extended. That looks really good. Extended kit with the little, okay. Lots of, they really like putting that bracket in there. Secondary with the hook. Okay. Bolstered bumper. That looks terrible. And that's all the options there. Okay. I feel like I like the extended bumper. The kit thing is kind of weird though. You know, it does kind of add some, I feel like extended bumper is the one for me there. Yeah, we'll do that. Okay. Engine block. So you have texture detail. Okay. You got the chrome, primary, secondary, carbon, sticker bomb, textured cam belt cover. Also, this one adds the, oh, this one adds the cam belt cover to it. Or the chrome, primary, that's sick. Alright, I like the cam belt cover, I think with the primary, we'll do that. Engine tune maxed out, brace, different strut braces there, this car has tons of customization. We'll do the billet, I like that. Engine detail, on this side, different carburetor setups. Muscle kit, GT kit. Also changes the intercooler up front as well. Wow. Okay then. I quite like the sports radiator. That looks really good, the detail on that. The muscle kit looks good too.
Whatever you desire. Technology and budget.
We'll go with that. Exhaust. So you got big bore. That looks really good. Rally, carbon, side pipes. Okay, but then you still have the hole back here. Doesn't look all that great. What is this? Oh, the stack exhaust. Pretty cool, actually. I like that one. But then you still have the hole back here. Six stack, flush hood. And you got it with the vent, the exhaust. What is this? Oh, out the side. Okay. Well, then with the vents. Oh my god, and exposed. With the vents. Wow, that's the craziest exhaust options I've seen in a while. All over the place, coming out of the hood, coming out of the side, coming out of the side of the fenders, coming out of everywhere. But ultimately, I mean, all of them still have this area back here that doesn't cover up. I think we definitely need to keep the exhaust here. And I quite like the big bore. It kind of gives us a nice custom look to it. But maybe it is a bit too big. I don't know. Doesn't look good though. I wish there was something in between. I guess this one is kind of in between. All right, we'll do that. This is like a resto mod at this point. You can remove the grill. Framed grill. Shark grill. Chrome. Carbon. The mesh. The diamond. Chrome diamond. Secondary. Okay. That's a tough one, honestly. I feel like the mesh looks good, but diamond. I think we should do the diamond grill, just the regular one. I feel like the stock one looks better though. I don't know. I feel like it goes with the car. That's a tough choice here. Let me know what you guys think down below in the comments which grill you like. I'm honestly, I definitely don't like the shark grill, but I do like the diamond grill. It's like a mesh. So I'm between the diamond and I don't like removing it completely, just a random hole there. So I'm between the stock and the diamond, but I feel like the stock when the lines kind of go with the bumper. But yeah, I'm gonna keep the stock grill. Hood, you can remove the hood. Okay, just straight up remove it. Okay, weight reduction. Then you got the carbon hood. Ooh, the ridged inset. I love that. Then you got the vented. And you got the sports, which is vented with the ridged, apparently. Okay. The vanity hood, the transparent window there. Or should I say just a little window so you can see it? Indent hood. A lot of vents. Oh, classic vent. Okay. That's a weird hood. The random vent there. Okay. I feel like I'm between the sports and the. I feel like this one just looks more clean, the ridged inset. Yeah, let's go with that. Lights, keep the white stock lights there. Liveries, get the hard stand livery, just the side stripe and one on the hood kind of ends there. Looks pretty good. Got the orange version of that. Oh, it takes up a lot of a splitter too. Oh, in the back, okay. Got the it's lower. You got some racing liveries. Okay. The hard stand livery is nice. I think I'm gonna go with that, honestly. Yeah, that looks really clean on there. I like that. Mirrors, you can remove the mirrors, and you can do ooh, the chrome mirrors. That's nice. Secondary, carbon, stylized. I don't like the classic mirrors. Let's do the chrome. That looks really good. I like that. Plates. Oh, I guess we'll throw our Ricola plate on there. I don't think I have a good plate for this one. Oh, JDM works, right? JDM plate. That works. Okay. Respray. So for this one, I've been going through a lot of the colors. I was thinking of blue, but I've done that in the past. For this one, I want sort of like a goldish color. You'll see here shortly. So I'm thinking a metallic wood beach brown. And then pearlescent, we're gonna do go all the way down here. pearlescent, we're gonna do a gold. And I think that just looks really, really good, especially in direct sunlight. It's just that sort of like goldish color. Just love the way it looks on there. Secondary color is going to be your door handles. No interior stitching must link to primary color, no brake calipers, and then I guess any of the secondary options you choose. So I think I'm just gonna go chrome on there. Get the chrome door handles, match our mirrors. Even though it is brighter than the mirrors, I think maybe we should go metals then? The brushed black steel? Yeah, it looks closer to the mirrors. So we'll do that. It's a little trick to get a darker chrome as the brushed black steel. A trim color is the interior for this. I definitely want a nice tan in here. White is too bright, so we'll go with a nice bleached brown. It looks really good. And then, man, I mean, I don't know. I feel like the cream looks better. Yeah, and the brown is too dark. Let's go with a cream. Chromium for this car goes on the doors. Okay. Spoiler upgrades. So you got a classic spoiler, carbon boot lip spoiler. Looks really good. Carbon version of that, secondary carbon. The dovetail spoiler, what's the difference? Oh, I see. It's got the little bolts there. Kind of like this one better, the boot lip spoiler. Black, you got the drift spoiler. That's too much, I think. then you got the section spoiler. Doesn't look quite right on this car. I mean, it goes all the way across, but just looks weird. I feel like it kind of ruins the body line on the side a little bit on the quarter panel coming to the bumper. But different color variations of that. Then you have race spoiler. You have a giant spoiler and that one too. Yeah, definitely the boot lip and primary. I think that looks perfect.
Looks almost as good as you.
Suspension, you can lower it, which I think we should definitely lower it all the way because it's that nice custom look. Transmission, turbo, wheels. So for this, I mean, I want to go with the street here with, where are they? These right here. These look really good. Yeah. Custom with a little deep dish effect to it there. We also look at the larger wheels, but yeah, I think they don't look as good. I also wanted to see how this one looks. Where is it? These. That's too big. Oof, no, that's way too big. That's too much. Okay, yeah, I think definitely, where are they? Yeah, these right here. We'll do that. A wheel color, I think I'm just gonna keep alloy. I feel like, you know, we can't really do any of these other ones. It just doesn't look right. You know, gold, just too much gold going on and stuff. So yeah, I think the alloy is the best route there, and the black just doesn't look right. Even though it kind of matches the livery, but I feel like with the alloy, it looks a bit better. Windows, I guess a little bit of light smoke just so it's not fully, you know, fishbowl transparent. And that's all the options here. All right, so I'm going to wait a little bit because it is dark outside currently in the game, so I can show you guys this paint color a bit better during the day. I don't usually do that, but I feel like this color deserves that. So I'll cut back here to us driving outside in the daytime. All right, the sun's coming out, so let's go ahead, exit to ground. Hopefully it's not raining. All right, a little foggy, but look at that paint. Oof, looks so good on this car. Shout out to Eatup for the idea for this color. He has like a modded version of this sort of like gold color, but this is the best I can get with, you know, standard GTA color mixing. I think it came out fantastic. All right, floor it. Sounds good. Thankfully, this car does not have handling flags, so it drives nice and normal. It's quick, man. Very, very quick. And if you don't factor in HSW, it's basically like a top 15 performing car on most tracks. I mean, you know, there's over 40 cars in the Sports Classics class, so it's not terrible for what it is. It's pretty decent. Especially for a car like this, it doesn't really look like it'd be that fast. I mean, this car easily could have been one of the slower ones in the class. The acceleration could be a little better, but I think it's good enough. Handling is nice, you know, for a sports classics car. It drives a lot better than most, that's for sure. It's not like the Casco with a super loose back end or the Coquette Classic. It you know, that spoiler upgrade definitely helps. Drives very nice for the most part. Little first person here, I love this interior. It's reused in, you know, like Rapid GT Classic and stuff like that. And there's different like iterations of it in other classic cars and such, but it's a really nice interior in this car. Love it, love it, love it. All right, let's pull over and open all the doors and stuff as usual. Good spot here. Yeah. Look at that paint color. I love that. All right. And the cream interior definitely gives it a nice contrast. Love the way this turned out. All right, vehicle doors, manage vehicles, preferences, and all. Now, something very, very cool in this car. If you go through the options here, you'll see, you know, you have the usual HUD, hood, roof. What am I saying? You have the roof. Let's take off the roof. It's not a convertible. You have the trunk, you have the hood, you have the rear right, and you have rear left. You might be like, what the heck? This is a two-door last time I checked. Well, that actually controls the little side compartments here. So you can see that. I went ahead and closed. It opens back up there. So then front left and front right, that would be your normal doors. And then rear, even though it's in the front, that would be your two little side panels there that open. That's just awesome. So why is that there? Well, like I said earlier at the beginning of the video, this car is based, you know, on the Fairlane EZ / Datsun / S30 mixed with the Toyota 2000 GT. And that car did have these little side panels that open the exact same way, pretty much. So Rockstar kind of carried that over into GTA, which I think is just really cool. Now, in real life, those compartments, one side was for the battery, and the other side was for the air filter and the washer fluid. So that's pretty cool the way they did that. Nice little thinking outside of the box there to put some of those components in, you know, a spot that, you know, didn't really clutter the engine bay, or maybe didn't fit in the engine bay, I don't know. But I think that's just really cool. And the fact that Rockstar carried that over as like a reference is just awesome. Engine bay, fantastic. Love it. And the primary color on that engine bay looks, on that valve cover, man, that looks good. I absolutely love that. That's beautiful. Very, very nice. Oof, the interior with the cream, the Karen floor mats. Man, this car is something else. GT. I wonder what that's referencing. Karen GT. I mean, it's a 190Z, so I'm not sure what that's referencing, but this is very, very nice. Got the little hatch here opening up the trunk. And this is textured too nicely. It looks almost like leather or something, like vinyl. That is, man, this car was done right. Let me tell you, this car, I mean, this thing is an A+. I mean, it checks all the boxes for me. And it's a shame that it's like a removed website car. That's a real shame. I mean, for those of you who don't own this car, you definitely need to own it. This thing, the customization is incredible. The detail, the interior, the engine bay, the little Easter egg reference with a little side compartment. I love that. I mean, it's just very, very well done. I mean, Rockstar did a fantastic job on this thing for sure. And then for some reason, they removed it, deeming it's a lesser used vehicle, which I find that kind of hard to believe. I'm pretty sure a lot of people own this car. Like I said at the beginning of the video, I will leave a video linked down below in the pinned comment explaining how to get remove website cars for those of you who don't know. But anyways, again, guys, thanks for watching. As always, let me know down below in the comments what vehicle you want to see me customize next, and I'll see you in the next one.